short updates lang doon sa development doon sa Happy Hero and yung Philippine fishing bangka na magkaroon ng collision sa ating fishing vessel actually. So that yesterday actually tapos na naman yung conduct ng investigation ng Coast Guard. And right now, Arman, ongoing pa yung ano, yung joint investigation.
Yes, sir.
Joint yung investigation ng Marina and the Philippine Coast Guard. So alam naman natin na yung Coast Guard yung in charge dun sa conduct ng port state control inspection. When we say port state control, yun yung pag-ensure natin ng compliance ng foreign vessels to the safety requirements. Yun ang ating chine-check pagka-conduct ng port state control inspection. So, pwede lang tayong mag-detain ng vessel through this function of the Coast Guard, through the port state control implementation, kung serious or severe yung kanyang violation when it comes to safety regulations. So sa sitwasyon na ito that the vessel violated the law of the land and meron tayong namatay sa atin and well of course para siguro natin na legitimate yung pag-detain natin sa kanya, so pinakandak natin siya ng investigation and after the conduct of investigation, we found it necessary for us to file a case to the master and the officers of the vessel. So as of yesterday at 4 p.m., the Coast Guard lawyer, of course, also the PNI, members of the PNI club were there. We filed a case. The Coast Guard filed a case to the master and the officers of MV Happy Hero at Antique Prosecutor's Office. Kahapon po yun, ang last 4 ng hapon. Ang charges na ibinigay nila sa kanila is reckless imprudence resulting to multiple homicide and serious physical injuries and damage to properties. So what we're waiting, yung court order na for the Coast Guard to detain the vessel, it necessitates appropriate court order. So yung court order na magsasabi sa amin na i-detain ninyo yung vessel because of these charges levied against them. So to make it sure that we'll have a sufficient ground na maging valid yung ating pag-file ng case, pinadive natin yon ng Coast Guard divers. So nakita natin doon na may scratches and may, sorry, not only dent, but damage yung part ng bulbous bow. When you say bulbous bow, yung matigas na part ng vessel sa ilalim. May damage siya. So it indicates that the vessel was involved in an accident. So from that, naging basis natin yun. Na yung barko talaga ay nagkaroon ng incident, involved sa incident. Hindi na po search and rescue operations ang meron tayo ngayon. Si nakailang araw na rin naman and we have exerted all efforts necessary. So right now nag-shift na tayo from search and rescue operations to search and retrieval operations. Hindi naman po natin ina-assume, never tayo na nag-assume na yung mga biktima natin, mga insidente ay namatay na. But of course, because of the recent development and na-cover na naman natin, we have done so much and we do hope also that the families of the victims will understand us. From the very beginning, kasama naman yun sa concept ng operations ng Coast Guard. Kailangan ay mag-usap natin yung pamilya and bigyan natin ng assurance that the government is really doing something para ma-atresan, hanapin, na makita yung pamilya nila na nawawala. Kasama po yan dun sa search and rescue doctrine natin.